Hey, I'm wishing you a Merry Christmas, hoping it's been a good week and that you've had time to rest and relax and enjoy a little bit of the season. Even we're in this alternative experience of Christmas. Hope it's been a good week for you. Today, I wanted to talk for just a minute about patience and waiting, because I think we are in for a long period of hopefully patient waiting as we wait for the vaccine to be distributed to successive layers of populations, and as we wait our turn patiently. I read an article that was about something that T.S. Eliot had written about waiting. And the whole point of the article was about the beautiful truth that if we approach waiting as kind of an endurance test, we miss all the gifts that might be available to us if we wait with an open expectancy. And this is what the writer said. We need to recalibrate our waiting and consider it as fertile ground, not just as a kind of a torturous, painful process. He said, waiting is not to be considered a stoic feat of endurance, but as a process that's transformative and rewarding in its unfolding. In other words, if you asked yourself, can I be open and receptive even after we've had months and months and months of deprivation and frustration at the experience of being isolated during COVID, what could I learn? What could I receive in these months that are left to try and create patient waiting, but also receptive and open waiting? I want to tell you a quick story about what happened the other day. I was in line waiting at the post office, and I got there very early before it started, and two people were in line ahead of me, and we were waiting in the inner waiting area before we got into the post office itself. And one of the people in front of me began humming. I couldn't really tell which person, and but all of a sudden, I recognized it's that beautiful old hymn, Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless God's holy name. And as the humming continued, it actually became some quiet singing, and it was lovely. So as the door opened, the line moved through, and the first person was waited on and left. And then the second person, who was the humming, singing person, decided that they had to have an exact type of stamp. It had to be the love stamp. It could not be a heart stamp. And she was being a little bit, as we'd say, nudgy, right, about what she wanted. But she was lovely, and the man behind the counter was lovely. And so when she turned around and said to the two people with me waiting, I'm sorry, I know I'm being a pain, I said, it's fine. You're good. It's great that you have an idea of what you'd like. And the woman also behind me said, well, what are we going to go home to except more waiting? So that gave me a chance then to compliment the woman on her singing, and that led to this very tender and dear conversation about faith and grace and God's presence in the time of waiting, and her prayers that, we would be quickly, that our country would quickly move toward health. And the world, and too, she included the world. But it was a surprising example of how being open to what just is, instead of staying focused on our frustration, can invite us to have new experiences of grace and goodness that we really don't expect. There's an old saying, don't just sit there, do something, right? And so I know that those of us who are action-oriented sometimes chomp at the bit to actually do something in these times of waiting. And if that's you, great. Knock yourself out, clean a closet, donate food to the food pantry, do something that's going to be productive for you. But the inverse is always true as well. Don't just do something, sit there. And if you can understand that God's grace can come to you in times of waiting, and that it can be fertile ground for new experiences of grace, then your heart will be in the right place to receive whatever gifts God has for you that day. So peace to you, and I'll talk to you in the new year. Take care.